Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen.
We are live from the CPTC live stream.
Was that your late night?
I really liked
like
it, Cal.
Jazz. Yeah, I think you should do that more.
I was getting like voiced by the fire. Like,
oh, yeah. Yeah, no, that was awesome. That was good vibes right there.
We get a lay down, break down boogie on the wrong side of town.
I am Matt McClure alongside Sean Albrecht and Cal Noble here from
What's
the CPTC
up,
live stream. We have the Legends event tonight.
Yes.
Let me explain this real quick for everybody, you know, not from the Chicago area, or maybe you are and you just need a quick introduction. The Legends event is something that got started over the past couple of seasons, and the design was sort of to take the top, let's call it 30 players in Chicago and have them pick a few nights, not every week, but, you know, once every other week or so, and play some really high-level matches. It's typically pros and tournament players, sort of the best of the best. And so tonight they are playing in they have the random formats that kind of mix it up. And so tonight is a little team event where each team is represented by a captain
that's
and they
cool
have six players.
Format,
yeah, it's a fun format. So this is court one of the match that we have tonight is Team Ong. Andrew Ong is the captain against Team Lombropoulos. Alex
yes.
Lombropoulos is the captain. But we are just going to get started here real quick, and everybody's going to fire it up. So this is a cool event. Over there on the far side in the red shorts is Robert Steinman, and he is playing with Peter Burka, who's the director at Sunset Ridge. And over here, just making contact in the white
nice.
Hat.
No
wow.
way. No way. Oh,
that was close.
Was going
in the white hat, closest to the camera here, is Mitch Granger with the newlywed Afterglow.
Yes.
Last week, Mitch and Spencer Granger now together officially. And then Andrew Ong, team captain, over there on the deuce side of the court, now switching to the ad.
What a dig.
So, yeah, this is going to be a fun one. These guys all like to grind it out and take big swings. So I'm really looking forward to it. Plus, we were just handed 14 pages of detailed notes on each player.
Yeah, what is that
which
all about?
We'll try. I don't know, but I love it. I think that it, you know, is probably...
This is a resume.
I like to go...
This entire
I like to go,
history.
You know, really deep in the research. But the research that I do is only things that I can find on, you know, social media.
It's crazy.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know. I think it's cool, but
yeah.
I mean,
if you've never
a
made
a
vine,
read.
Then I don't know anything about you.
It's a lot to read.
Well, I mean, you know, we're getting into it.
Yeah,
I'm sure we're gonna play a nice long grind style match here. Oh, that was a really smooth drive there from Andrew.
All right, 30
so,
love.
30 love. Yeah. So this format is cool. It's sort of nice.
Yes.
Good hands there by Mitchell. The format sort of came out of
nice
kind of,
pick.
I guess, more recently with the depth that's been coming into Chicago Paddle. Series one with, you know, trying to field, you know, eight teams at series one and getting, you know, four courts, you know, per team.
Yes.
Was sort of getting a little difficult,
not
right?
Not easy to do.
Yeah, maybe courts one and two were kind of series one, and then there might have been some, you know, not to say that anybody was bad, but sort of a little drop-off in level, maybe some filler.
Just a little bit.
Which, you know, that's the only reason I ever got to play Series 1, so I was
Stop.
Glad to have that opportunity. but I do kind of like the format here because it
yeah.
makes it a little bit easier. This is a good one for a lot of the guys that are playing in the Medina tournament coming
yep.
up this weekend, so this is like a great opportunity to get some, you know, some practice reps in at a really high level, but... you know, nobody's concerned about walking away with a trophy from the league on this
no.
particular.
No. But it's the idea is that, you know, it's more of a almost an exhibition, if you will.
Yeah.
You know, I think that's I know that sounds like, well, they're not really playing for keeps. No, these guys want to win.
No, yeah, everybody wants it. And this is cool because so many of these guys get to play together so regularly.
Oh, yeah.
That there's, you know, there's a lot of opportunity where they know each other's game and. You know, it's fun on the style side.
Well, I can tell you, after looking at the bios which we were given, which and
nice
what
move,
I like,
Mitch!
Wow.
Wow, good hands.
What I like is that we're given the bios literally 3 seconds before we come on the. Which I just love that. Like,
well, I mean, you know, we'll just. I think that every 3 points, we'll just read one.
That's
fact.
What I was going to do.
Nice cutter, good hands.
Go. That's a good waterfall.
Oh.
It's there, but
and it
Andrew
caught the top
is,
beam.
Yeah, I thought that was out of there. Maybe.
What you'll notice here is, despite all the activity that's happening, Peter Burka's heart rate will not get above 15 beats per minute, possibly at any point in the match, but especially during this point.
No.
When he's in this position, he's going to do his job. He's going to take little steps. You saw him bounce around a little bit there, but that's just a waste of precious calories.
That's EOM Burka, economy of movement.
Keeping it smooth.
No, he is basically the definition of smooth.
Yeah, he's always you don't have to run around a lot if you're always in the right spot. So
absolutely.
It's a nice little poke drive there from Andrew off the backhand side. He can really crank the two if he gets the opportunity as well.
Exactly.
But
let's throw a little dynamic in here, coaches, because you got three veritable, even though they're all young guys, even Pete compared to me, so I figured I'll call him a young guy. But they're three veterans pretty much. And then Mr. Steinman is, although he's, you know, a youngin as well, but he hasn't been playing paddle for quite as long, but he's got such great racket skills from the tennis court. He showed up, and now he's kind of, you know, it's kind of disgusting how good he's gotten.
I think at
over
this
the
point,
past 3 years.
I think at this point he's played plenty.
Absolutely.
Nice try there by Mitch to dip that ball, but just a patient enough point from Burka Steinman. We're going to hope the music outside is just quiet enough to not get us a copyright strike on the stream.
Yeah. Wow.
If at all possible. That's that two-hander that I was talking about from Andrew. Maybe
is
a little late on
pulling
the trigger.
Print out Google Sheets?
Well, no. Yeah, well, there's that, too. Yeah, there's printed out Google
Listen,
Sheets.
Listen, if you can go three pages deep on
Sorry,
Google.
Sorry, just won that point. That was
Steinman and Burka.
So we got 30 low.
On that one. That's a nice return there.
It was.
Great move.
Is anybody else smelling pineapples?
Smelling pineapple?
Yeah.
I think that there's some craft IPAs floating around in the hut at the moment.
The incredible smell of the Medina Country Club.
That's so good.
That's not sarcastic. I actually like the smell. I like the smell.
That's how good, how high tech our live stream is. You can actually get fragrance.
If you
it's a scratch and sniff stream.
Scratch and sniff.
Everyone walk to your closest monitor or screen and see what you can pick up.
Absolutely.
We've paid extra for this technology, and we're going to use it.
So I'm going to say every two games we read a little bit of something here, Coach, because I
Oh, yeah.
There's a
I
lot
mean, you,
here.
You dump it in anytime you want. Good move.
Oh, okay. So we'll have to do it with all that's there. We may have to go every point.
Yeah.
Little blurb. And it is a grind fest so far, Coach.
Starting to see that Burka precision.
Yeah.
Mitch really does have cat-like reflexes.
No, he's a Granger's. Yeah.
See, I would say he reminds me of a cat, but people would take that as an insult. I'm a cat person, so that's a
compliment. Well, I guess
compliment.
It's in there.
Oh.
No. Way to leave it.
But, he's very graceful on his feet.
Definitely.
The Grange Rover. I'm on the Grange.
I'm trying to get. I guess I should go right to Mitch's page here if I'm going to do something. Wait a minute. Hold on. I don't have a page for Mitch. Hold up.
We can rattle that off the top of our heads.
Well, yeah, we can fill that in. 6'8", no problem.
280.
Pure muscle.
Yeah.
Played at UIC. Solid racket skills. One of the few guys on the court that has been hitting the ball since he was, 10 years old or whatever.
Absolutely.
With his dad.
Double majored in law and business at Harvard.
Did he really?
Oh,
what
yeah.
What are you talking about? He actually completed two seasons at Western Illinois for the Leathernecks, Coach. Did you know that?
I did not, no.
Yeah. Yeah, he led Western Illinois in total singles victories, 11, during the 2012-13 season.
That's amazing.
Talk about a testament
to Mitch.
Finally
bringing some notoriety to Western Illinois.
The Leathernecks.
Exactly.
That's a great roller from Steinman to find the corner.
As a testament to Mitch Granger's physique, Sean didn't bat an eye when we said he was 6'8", 280. But when we said he went to Harvard,
it was like, I don't think so.
Now he's 7 foot, 330 pounds.
Pure muscle, though.
Absolutely.
Is it possible to break the... This is a question about the human physique. Is it possible to break the 300 barrier and still look lean?
Like, I've been doing it for years.
Yeah, I think it is. I just think, you know, you have to be built like all that right. guy from Game of Thrones, the mountain.
The beast. Is probably,
yes, yeah. yes, yes, you can say bamboo shoots, by the way.
Probably bamboo shoots, there we go. Sean, bamboo hit us with some facts. Around. We're two games in.
Okay, all right. Let's go with somebody I haven't even talked about, really, is Andrew Ong, who is just, speaking of a blur, the man's got speed in spades. He played at Duquesne, really? Isn't that Spencer Caravaggio, now Granger, territory coach?
I think they were friends from school.
Yeah, he was apparently a male athlete of the year.
Well,
I mean, that's kind of redundant,
really,
isn't it?
Not really a surprise, but...
It's redundant, though. We didn't have to say that. Could we just say athlete of the year? We kind of knew.
I don't like it when a guy who, you know, with his level of talent already, also, like, before the match is eating boiled chicken breast and raw broccoli. It's like, dude, it's fine. You're everything's going to be fine.
Yeah.
That was a laser beam from Steinman out of that backhand side.
Well, he says, being new to Chicago, one of his quotes was, he's been welcomed with open arms by the entire paddle nation.
That's true.
Yeah. One of the hardest workers on the game, according to some. And
I would agree with that.
Plays tour events as much as anyone. He plays with multiple partners. Everybody loves the guy.
He is really awesome. I don't want to take anything away from him, but it's also pretty easy to be accepted by the paddle community when you walk on the court and you're that good.
Yes.
You know, yeah. It's almost cheating.
No question about
it. Everybody would like me, too, if I had that kind of natural talent.
Yeah.
Seriously.
He can always get a game. Everybody wants to be his partner.
Bet you he's invited to parties. I wonder what that's like. He was a starter on the college tennis team at Duquesne all 4 years.
Oh, laser. Caught a little off the calf as he tried to get out of the way to let that ball go.
I like the
Mitch. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
I was just going to say, the higher you get in paddle, the less people care, because if you watch Series 4, if they hit a ball near someone, they apologize. He just hit him, just turned the other way. And it's not a disrespect. It's just a normal thing that goes on.
That's just part of the game.
Used to it. Yeah.
Yep.
That's right.
It wasn't going to be out or anything. It's not like you hit him in the face.
Yeah.
Okay, that was pretty much a sick backhand return from Rob Steinman. I'm just going to say that.
That was a good shot.
And since Mitch was wanting to hit the serve, I'll talk Mitch. He was a wealth manager for – is he a wealth manager right now for Northwestern Mutual?
I believe so, yes.
And he just did get married.
That's what he's doing currently. Good shift to the drive.
And Coach – Man mentioned it earlier. He just did get married to Spencer Caravaggio.
Formerly.
Caravaggio, yeah.
Yep.
He was one of the best paddle players in the area as well in the country. Talk about a great mixed team. Jeez.
Yeah, that'll be serious. Yeah, the married mixed is about to have a new seed,
two.
I think.
I don't think that's as much talent as you're going to get out there.
There's a lot of good teams out there, but that is going to change the dynamic a little bit.
Yeah.
And Mitch isn't a paddle pro or tennis pro, so he can actually have free time, which is
nice.
Exciting for that age group.
Completely unacceptable.
Yeah.
You know, I thought it was the most hated commentator out here. Now, Cal, you've just taken...
Oh, what a dig!
Just taking the lead right there.
Hey, as someone who's worked as a tennis associate and gotten overwhelmed, I can only imagine what a director has to do.
That's not saying a lot there, Cal.
All right.
anyway.
As a disciple of Mike Raleigh,
great players,
I would argue I am tennis royalty compared to you.
who do you
have under your belt? Who's your mentor?
That's a good pick.
I have a million of them. So it's difficult to say.
Exactly.
But I'll tell
it's
you
like
this much.
Coward
First
response.
Of all, can we say this? I don't think you could find four nicer guys on the court. Am I wrong?
Yeah, no, this is a solid group.
Yeah. Everybody, there isn't anybody out here who people complain about, at least not in front of them.
Although I did ask him to, you know, get into some kind of conflict to help the ratings.
People love that stuff.
I scripted it. I scripted a fight for him.
Exactly. Well, one other interesting thing about Mitch, he's number four nationally in father-son in tennis.
Yes.
With his dad.
That makes perfect sense. Ed Granger.
Eddie is phenomenal. What a great player.
Ed Granger is actually what the Legends League was named after.
Is it really?
That's the whole reason. Well, I'm going to start it now.
All right. You know what? I buy it. I bought it. I didn't even blink. Anyway.
Jeez.
That's a sick pace on that backhand side. And speaking of Robert
Steinman,
let's talk about Rob for a little while. Played high school tennis at New Trier. Two-time state champion in singles, by the way. Let's know that. I watched that, some of it, firsthand.
I was there.
He got... There I was.
There I was.
It's like Commander McBragg.
You'll never believe it.
Quite.
I was there.
There I was. He was ranked as high as 2 in the nation, by the way, when he was in the juniors, and a number one college recruit. He went to Stanford. Played 6 as a freshman. I watched him do it. Won the Midwest Championships. Wow. All-American in 2015 for Stanford, team captain.
Yeah, he's got quite the resume.
Oh, yeah.
Speaking of resuming, we're about to get back underway here.
So he's got...
the all-important fourth game.
Exactly.
Coming at you right here.
No home court advantage,
though.
It's
only a break if you hold.
Yeah, it's true. Anthony McPherson is here somewhere.
Yeah, he's the home
pro. He's got a home court advantage.
Yeah, wonderful director, by the way. Anthony is awesome. Let's see. So said to have, quote, and this is probably from his platform tennis mentors, but in tennis, one of the best backhands, if not the best backhand in all of college tennis. So that last backhand was not a fluke. the one we saw, it was a laser beam.
I assumed that was the first one he's ever hit.
He shut his eyes.
I thought he just got lucky.
He closed his eyes. And swung. No,
that's a blind random swing.
Exactly.
That happened to connect.
He names platform tennis mentors here, though, Coach.
That's pretty awesome.
Mike Marino, Tad Eckert. I don't know. Well, I guess Tad Eckert would be a good paddle player. He's a great tennis player.
Peter Burka. That's a good move by
Mitch.
Actually,
he's there. Peter and Paul Rose. Ben McKnight, Alan Graham. James Goodman and Scott Bondurant. Anyway, he works currently for Bain Management Consulting.
So he knows a few people.
Yeah.
That's impressive.
Good for Ron. Well, anyway, happy to have him. And then we saved Pete Burka, the man, the machine, the legend. Nice dig.
Director at Sunset Ridge.
Exactly. He was a star tennis player, actually, at Northern Illinois in the early 1990s, was Pete Burka.
The 90s. What a
time to be alive.
What a generation.
The Pete. I'm just kidding. I'm just calling him Pete. I don't know. It was a Seinfeld joke and a double entendre at the same time, and it got nothing. So, anyway, he won 22 singles matches his freshman year. Jeez. That's a lot. Considering I played enough college tennis. I don't think I won 22
nice
singles
move,
matches in my life.
Good hands by Peter to recover there. And
let alone in college.
Mitch stayed up knowing that Andrew was going to drive that ball back off the screen.
That's called experience, Coach. That's called experience.
It's big. The transition game is super important.
Yes.
Especially, you know, still playing some warm weather paddle here, so the opportunity is there.
I was just going to say that it is still technically warm weather. 58 degrees, maybe 56.
It's my favorite
degrees.
Part about starting out is the amount of times I get to hear warm weather paddle.
For the first part of the season?
Yeah. And then the end of the season, too. I feel like it's, I would say, 45% of matches warm weather paddle gets
You know
set.
What's funny is that we call it warm weather paddle, but the reality is true paddle weather where it's like 12 degrees,
blitz.
No one really likes.
Because it's 12 degrees.
Yeah, I'll just go ahead and say it. Yep. Like, paddle is meant to be played somewhere between 30 and 70 degrees. And any time that it's below that, it's just not. You're just like, why are we here?
Every degree below 60 takes a percentage of my willingness to participate in this.
Nice.
So when we're at zero, I'm rocking.
Actually, you know what? I'll tell you what. I don't want 40, even if it's raining, though. Like, beat down raining. Forget it.
That's a good point. It doesn't matter what temperature it is.
Exactly.
If it's raining, it's not
fun. It's not working. I mean, some people love it. I just can't. But just because I can't is not an endorsement. So Pete was a paddle premier cup winner with Drew Eberle years ago, if you remember that event.
Yeah, I think P. Burka has a has a whole bunch of paddle cred. I mean, he's been playing for a while and
instructional paddle books,
all kinds of stuff going on, teaching, playing, modeling.
Apparently, there's last but not least, has probably been influential to our game as anybody. I think that's true. I think that, especially in Chicagoland area, everybody knows Pete Burka, PB. Absolutely.
I mean, his early instructional video might have the most views of anything paddle related. Absolutely. Or it's got to be close.
No. Speaking of close, nobody does a close up better than Pete Burka in the videos if you've ever seen him.
Yeah, especially when he walks up with the window frame already around his neck.
That's my favorite.
Yeah, that's a good one. It's got so many views because I watch it six times a day.
All right, so I thought it was just me.
I have a question for you guys.
Sure.
Obviously, Andrew Wong is an incredible paddle player, and he is not short of confidence. Does it ever get under your skin as a player if they just keep hitting the balls to you? Like, does that ever just kind of, like, rub you the wrong way or, like, make
you feel
insulted?
I think that it's always, like, sort of part of the game. But I also think that there is an element to, everybody will have, you know, sort of a mental place where I don't know if it will bother them as much as you can sort of get taken out of your groove.
They're kind of cooling you off.
Yeah, sort of. I mean, like, if you get isolated for an extended period of time, you know, especially it can be difficult if you're not finding opportunities to drive, or maybe if you made a couple errors and so you're trying to play really steady, it's hard to re-engage, you know, after playing just a long point where your only goal is keeping the ball in the court.
The other thing, Coach, great, great point. The other thing is, you got to realize that the percentages at the intermediate stages are with the player that generally, if it's a righty-righty combination, sticks to the backhand side or the ad side. So
great shot right
on
the line.
You're going to see, if you play the ad side, you're going to feel like you're getting picked on on a regular basis, because that's the percentage side anyway. If you play, you've got righty-righty, generally.
Yeah, okay. That can be part of it.
But these guys are so good, you know, they'll swing the ball at will. But the idea is, you know, what we coach, if we go out, teach I don't want to say just a lower series, lower than one, by the way, maybe way lower than one, or the double digits. Yeah, you're gonna see a lot more players that are going to be picking on the ad side because that's how they're coached.
You'll also see, especially at this level, you'll see a whole bunch of kind of half-speed drives.
Yes.
And, you know, a lot of times you might say, well, what's the point of that? Like, it's not like somebody's missing the volley. It's sort of so you can keep your groove.
Yes.
Right? Because it's really hard. If you hit 40 lobs in a row and then you swing as hard as you can on a drive, it might not be, you know, it might not be in rhythm.
No. No, not only that, I mean, this is another, I don't know, it's a lesser, I should say, a lesser advertised fact about racket sports in general, not just paddle. But the harder you hit the ball from your side, the quicker it can come back.
Yeah.
Sometimes you're doing yourself a disservice, smacking a drive because the ball comes back so fast, you got to react to it. So sometimes a drive with a little less pace on it is actually a better idea.
Nice hands. You know, that's actually one of the things that Mitch has gotten a lot better at, especially with his drive, is, you know, hitting it with enough spin and trying to focus on getting the ball to dip, and then he'll close the net a lot. And it really has sort of been a big opportunity in his game, where it's not waiting for them to miss the volley as much as it's, you know, taking advantage of a volley that floats a little bit.
Funny you say that. I've been watching Mitch for maybe 2 years now, you know, and he's just improved exponentially in those 2 years.
And he was already good to begin with.
Exactly. But I'm just saying, it just, you could see it. He's just, you know, more comfortable, way more consistent.
Man, at the net, Robert just has weapons on both sides. It's
apparently,
like, it's not an advantage to get him to transition, you know, to the other side. He just rolls his backhand so well.
You know, it's funny because I talk about his forehand, which is a seed, by the way. That is a laser beam. But his backhand's actually a better shot.
I mean, it is interesting to kind of, under normal circumstances, when you hit a good lob down the line and you can get somebody to go backhand, you're feeling like you're in control of the point.
Yep.
And when he gets a backhand, it's just an opportunity to snap off a roller.
It's true.
Doing a good job here in the middle, defending space there. Mitch and Andrew were in sort of sharing the middle, especially when the ball's got that much spin coming off the back screen.
Undoubtedly. Here's an add point here. Add in, by the way, to break up a Deuces Wild tie. Here in the first set at Lovely. Yes, bucolic. Yes, because the leaves are turning, you know. Medina
Country
Club.
Shift. Laser.
Yeah.
One of the things that you also see in terms of just reading the point as it develops,
yes,
is all four of these guys, when they think a drive is coming, they will just stand just right on top of the net.
Oh, yeah.
And they step up. They step up before the ball is hit.
Oh, yeah.
That's why it takes two or three good shots in sequence to really get anybody uncomfortable. Good defense there.
Matter of fact, that's probably what these guys, if some of you are watching at home or wherever you are,
or in the car,
all four of you, you're watching at home and you don't necessarily play at this level, which most people don't. Let's just face it, these guys are creme de la creme. That's why they're here. But you know what you just mentioned, Coach, is a great point. Part of it is anticipation. You pretty much know what's coming. One shot ahead, and if you get to a point here,
that's tough.
Shot,
that's a great volley by Peter.
And you know what? The best thing about it was it didn't have enough pace on it for really to match the mission, do anything. It was just going to die at the side screen, which are the biggest nightmares, by the way.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. It was almost a tomahawk.
I mean,
how fast
Andrew's
is
speed.
Andrew on?
Yeah, good lord.
Jeez. It's like about floating over there. It was crazy.
Nice dig. Came over to help out. Mitch made that commitment on the drive.
Sure did.
Couldn't get up to the ball.
I love
this
move.
Oh, nice.
I love this move. Maybe he hit the backhand a little too hard almost, but what
yeah,
a beautiful move. No,
but
no,
you feel like
in
you have
weather,
to.
Anyway, in
yeah,
this weather, you know?
You sort of feel like you have to do something with the ball, hoping
yeah
that. I mean, I think he was trying to hit it right at Peter. It's just
yeah
that Peter's tough to hit.
Yeah, he is. Wonder what that's like. I think you take three of Pete, and that's me as wide as you know I would be.
That is just a hair deep. Wow, a couple of long deuce points here.
And we arrive at a break point here.
This is smart here from Mitch and Andrew to change up their formation a little bit.
I like that move.
Steinman's return is a nightmare, so
yes, apparently
gonna have to make some
it'd be
adjustments.
Nice if he, you know, just was human enough to miss one. It would be.
Yeah, you really got to stretch him out. He's missed a couple of screen drives in the tape, but otherwise, it's just a little deep.
Wow. Dug out of there. Back to deuce.
Deuce number three.
You know,
four?
I was half kidding about the grind fest, but you know, I guess. And this isn't really grind anyway, because they are hitting the ball.
It's entertaining.
It is.
Yeah.
Peter wants that one back because he knows that it wasn't enough of a surprise factor to really add a lot of pressure.
And also, he hit it in the net.
And he can hold here.
No, just what
probably,
I said. Kyle,
probably,
not the
probably
net.
Wants,
he could care less about the net.
It.
He was aiming for the net.
Yes.
Oh,
yes.
Put a little sizzle
you know, you
on
had,
that
I was
one.
Kind of waiting. You,
yeah, do
we
you guys
get
remember
deuce
that?
Points.
Yeah. Last time we did the Legends, I think at Inverness last year, he hit like eight of those and did not miss a single one until
yeah
the end.
Yeah, he had a pretty serious percentage going.
Him and I want to say Tyler Hansen, but that's
exactly
not his
right
last name.
No.
Tyler
Frazier.
Adam Morgan's Frazier. Yeah.
Frazier.
Also has a wicked slice.
Yeah, when he's on, he doesn't miss a cutter either.
Yeah.
Anyway. See, this is what I mean. They're social in the middle of the night. This is the way you're supposed to do it. You know what I mean? All these gotta focus stuff. I don't know. Just
well, thanks
I
to our sponsors as well. Viking, Illinois
yes
Bone and Joint, and
Wind Trust.
Viking in particular, as they are a sponsor of the Legends League.
Is that right?
Itself, yeah. Very specifically. So always cool of them to promote that high-level paddle here in Chicago, make it possible, provide the balls.
I want to say the most popular ball in the nation. Am I wrong, Coach?
I mean, I think that is accurate. Yeah, I think it's the number one. It's the number one ball.
Definitely most requested.
I enjoy the Viking product. Always sleek and smooth.
Yeah.
I'll never play with anything else. And that's not just because I had, you know, a conversation with Matt Wurzel at the wedding. I love that guy. Always entertaining.
He's a nice guy.
Yep. Sick volley there. You know, what is interesting about Steinman, if there's anything, you know, that is sort of like kind of left over from his tennis game,
days.
As you were talking about, maybe
sure.
He, you know, I mean, not, it's got to be close with him and Andrew in terms of the amount of paddle that they've played. I mean, but his first volley always looks like a tennis first volley to me, which you can get away with
yeah.
when you have that kind of talent. But it's
yeah.
funny how he's short, sort of like he gets low
split
and there's like a little there's
step.
A little hop
yep,
to
yep,
it, you know.
Yep, yep.
Whereas I think yeah. most of the volleys that you'll see Peter Burka hit tonight, both feet will be firmly planted
right,
on
right,
the ground, you
right.
know, in kind of that purist paddle stance. It's just
yep.
cool to see the styles.
Oh, yes. Actually, the amazing thing is, and I know it's not super warm out there, but the amazing thing is he's able to do that in, quote, warm weather paddle. Not easy to do because if you can't get planted, it's tough to get a...
I've always felt like that as well. When it's
yeah.
warm and somebody really cracks a return, it's
yeah.
tough to keep that first volley in play if you're not...
Stationary.
Stable.
No,
yeah,
you're right.
You just got to be stable,
you.
But... But when you stretch and, you know, can absorb pace like all these guys can, then
yeah.
it changes the dynamic a little bit.
I think they call it macho, Coach.
Ooh.
Something I'm unfamiliar with.
They wrote a song about that.
What about a racket sports-based high school band called the Pace Absorbers?
Wow. That sounds like a John Irvin product.
No, their first single would be Don't Need No Dampener.
I like it.
Be great. The Metronomes.
Actually, if you just put a girl's name in front of the dampener, it works. Just go like Bonnie's Dampener. That would be the name of it.
Bonnie's Dam.
No, not Bonnie. I don't think Bonnie works. No offense to Bonnie's out there.
Oh, that was a cool shot.
It never ceases to entertain me to watch a two-hander hit a one-handed drive off the screen, Coach.
Oh, yeah.
And do it successfully. That was a perfect example of that. Andrew, speaking of talent with a capital T, what a return.
Yeah.
And the volley
it is
sick.
It is always cool to see when players can do both,
yeah.
you know. Like, obviously, off the deck, Andrew's playing those as a, you know, a two-handed backhand
yeah.
drive, and then when it comes high out of the screen, it's almost
yep.
always a one-hander.
Yeah, and he's just really good at it. Nice shoulder turn. The sad thing is, all I have is a one-hander, and his one-hander looks better than mine. He's a two. So,
well, you got to have options.
What are those?
Oh, good defense
no way.
From Pete
Come
there.
On.
Yeah. Oh,
you get off.
That bit hard.
It did. Kind of as a seamer almost here, Coach, but it couldn't have been kind of off the side. I guess
it just landed deep enough in the court where it's just a very little reaction time
yeah.
when it corkscrews that fast.
Because it's a nice wide surf hitting the nick on that from Granger.
So this is kind of interesting because I talk a lot about team dynamics. And one of the things that is a sort of a unique benefit here for Steinman and Burka is that Burka plays, his drives are just so placement
wow.
oriented
yeah.
that sometimes it can screw you up with the change of pace. Right?
Exactly.
So in terms of back-to-back drives, like, you know, Steinman might rip the cover off the ball, but then Peter will get this little fluttery thing to dip. You know,
holy serve.
Nice serve.
What a serve.
Gee.
Granger.
And then followed up
Perfect.
By, we didn't really talk about it, but Ong just nailed another cutter to win
yeah.
a point there. I mean, that was.
Two
that
for
might
two.
Have been the greatest paddle serve I've ever witnessed.
Two for two.
I cannot think the amount of times where I've seen a serve win because it was actually too fast.
Yeah, it happens occasionally, yeah. but I mean, it's a great, you know, it's a great surprise factor. Every once in a while, he just hit it flat at the corner.
Coach, we don't have like a computerized female voice for the statistician. I didn't just hear a whisper say 2 for 2. That was you, right?
I mean, I can.
2 for 2.
I do it. I like to.
It is getting near Halloween. I'm starting to feel.
I like to do it as the, you know, as the navigational Siri voice every once in a while.
I like that. I do the same thing. If there's
turn
a
around.
If there's a, I do the whisper
please
voice.
Please place your item in the bagging area.
If there's water in the phrase, I like it like lakes.
Just a little wide.
Chino Lakes.
You know, Peter Burka reminds me a lot of Johan. Just like, he's just so cool on the court. Like,
Johan,
it just seems like nothing could bother him. Durant.
Durant. Okay.
I call Johan a reptile because
Peter
it just
is
seems
going
like
to,
nothing affects him. But he's
Peter
like the
is going to really
ever
appreciate that comparison.
He was, yeah.
Well, but it's just the way he carries himself. He's not hunched over. He just looks like he could be playing any number of sports right now.
He like could he, do anything.
Yeah, and but he's nailing it. I mean, it's very impressive.
Yeah, it's true.
It's like a level to something. It's like Nadal versus Federer, I guess. Which one's better? Someone who looks like they put in a ton of effort or someone who just looks effortless?
That's a good point.
My vote's for Federer, but I'm biased because that
yeah
guy has to smell fantastic, as I mentioned every time. He has his own cologne line, Roger Federer
he's
for Swiss? Men.
Because
he no, because he's Roger Federer. You think that guy smells bad?
Huge backhand.
Big dig by Mitch as well. Good dig, yep. Steinman,
okay,
the drive off the roller,
yes,
by the way.
I mean, disgusting. I'm going to say it, too. His footwork, and again, I'm probably talking more tennis even than paddle saying this, but his footwork is flawless. Dude, I mean,
yep,
that backhand
yep
was, I mean, it, I'm telling you, seen enough tour tennis, that was just breathtaking, so to speak. Gets a nice lob off the back foot there, which not easy to do. Oh,
that's
died
big
in the corner.
40-30.
Kind of like my dating career and homecoming.
30-40, right? Excuse me.
Just in the corner,
no,
just
I think
dying
it is 30-40.
Yeah, I think
okay
so, too. It is 30-40.
Oh, we got a little
wow
flute solo.
Blues Traveler.
That's actually it's that's a harmonica there, Junior.
I couldn't really hear it, so I stand by the flute solo.
Stand by the flute solo.
I can't see Blues Traveler, the guy that sings lead playing the flute. I just it's just not there.
Well,
I mean,
that's
because sure
it's not
could
happening right in front of us.
He's got a great voice.
The only thing you can see is a paddle court.
That's true. Like I said, I don't think he's missed a backhand.
I think one of the most frustrating things about paddle at this level
yeah
is you can do everything right where you hit
point
the perfect shot into the corner
yep
and somebody reads it well and they drive it back at you. The shot that's supposed to have a reward where
yes,
it shoots
exactly
out and that was stayed really low.
Way low.
There's that. Another good backhand roller from Steinman.
Yeah,
we'll
so
call that guy under the radar. That's his call sign.
Get in.
Oh,
he got it.
He
got
made
it
work.
Good hustle there, Rob.
Good dig by Peter as well.
And since Sean always, like, I guess I was going to say preface, but not preface, but after he says something like that, he says we're not rooting for anybody, but he didn't say that this time. So are you rooting for Mitch Granger?
Yep.
You know what? You got to root for the married guy.
I was just going to say, if you're Peter
he's on
and
technically
Robert,
on his
like,
honeymoon.
I feel like the universe
yeah
is against them in this match.
Well, I mean, I don't mean to root one way or the other. I'm just saying, you know, he's such a nice guy.
Clips the tape
a big
and drifts
for him
wide.
I know Spencer. She's
yeah
a lovely lady.
4-3.
You know, it's hard not to. I don't know. You know, sue me.
What's your email address?
Well, yeah, but probably one of those situations where he can't get yelled at for, like, staying late at a paddle match, you know? it's just like when
that's
a
good point.
You don't get to marry a teaching pro, you know, and then be like, oh, well, I'm so, why were you gone so long?
Wait, you've been stalking me? since I've been dealing with that all week. Where have you been? No, my wife's not like that. Matter of fact, is who are you? Oh, that's right. You live here.
All right, 3-4.
That was a good
rip
return
there.
That mm-hmm thing dropped like a stone.
And just enough
yep.
on the right hip of Steinman where as he shifted to the middle, it just got a little jammed on him.
Exactly. It's tough also.
It was a great blitz from Mitch.
Right
seeing
hip,
that
so to speak. It was.
Drive coming. Another laser beam. Just on that ball so early.
He's got a good touch.
It's a good ball from Mitch to get that to drop below the
really
net.
Really good touch. I was going to use the word rolling, but that's just a bad pun. Isn't that terrible? The stuff you've come up with.
It's a great serve from Peter.
Wow. You know what? Touche.
Yeah.
Let's face it.
Catching the right angle off the back screen where it was so high as it was dropping off the side.
Exactly.
It's a tough read.
It's like Harry Potter.
Nice
oh,
shot.
Oh, it's
We're
a good
stay
move.
In there. Okay, now I'm just going to say it because this is what we coach when we do coach, right? Well, I would have suggested at the lower levels bailing after the first one. and Steinman stays in there because
the
you know you're going to get this.
The
well,
best part about this
Rob
level
Steinman
is that they don't follow the rules
net.
At
exactly,
all.
Exactly, yeah, yeah. I saw Steinman stay at the net between those shots, and I don't understand why you tell us to bail, and I'm kind of like...
Well,
right,
I was
look.
Watching the live stream, and they did all the things
exactly.
you said not to do.
So
oh, sorry.
We'll hear about it later.
We really need a CPTC live bingo chart, because that would be on there for sure. Complaining about members.
Just enough kick on it.
And then there's
yep. a little bit of a problem. He always almost put that off. What?
I don't know if this was last year, but it's definitely this year. And you go, you know what? I'm just going to say it. And then you leave a pause. And there's this video out there that I don't think most of our viewers are getting. Matt probably knows, but it's this kid from like high school. And he's in a computer lab. And he goes, you know what? I'm just going to say it. I don't care that you broke your elbow. And everyone goes, oh.
yeah.
And like, it's just the way you say it is the exact
yeah.
same
you
way
really?
That he starts
you know
it.
What?
And
I'm
just
going
to
say it.
I want to, every time you go, I'm just going to say it. I don't care that you broke your elbow.
I don't care that you broke your elbow.
It's, yeah.
it's
so
like
weird.
Middle school.
And yet
yes.
It's so weird, and yet it's funny. So that works out. Nice volley, Pete. Pete. Ah, the Pete. I know. That the Seinfeld joke will just never get old. It's already old, Sean. Waterfall.
I totally did not miss that camera angle because I was looking up the video.
At least you admit it. Or didn't
no,
admit,
I didn't.
You did
I'm not
it,
admitting
actually.
Anything.
Well, what else is new there?
Don't worry about
I'm
it.
A
it's
pathological
perfect.
Liar.
Yeah, you're a sociopath. You're
that's
nice
like the Norm dig. McDonald. Well, whatever. I won't bring that up on stream.
Nice.
But I think we all know the joke
we'll
I'm talking about.
Save that
we'll
one
leave
for
it
later.
Yeah. Wait, what
that's for
do?
The Patreon.
What are we
going to
do? A podcast? Yeah. Save it for the podcast?
Okay. Come join us on Patreon, CBTC
live
stream.
Exclusive all new interviews with the commentators. Nobody asked for it, but now you get to pay for it.
That is a great slogan. Nobody asked for it, but now you get to pay for it. CBTC live stream. What a dig.
You can always dredge up my favorite one of my favorite slogans
digging.
From Paddle Hacks. All talk and no talent.
All talk, no talent.
I love that one.
I've always felt that way, and it's still true.
Every time somebody trips, my go-to is ambition well ahead of adhesion. It's Martin Brundle.
Yes.
Just looking up the, I don't care that you broke your elbow. I think you know you've made it as an internet video when there is a widescreen version that's literally just labeled widescreen.
Do you remember, like 3 years ago when, like, vertical video was stupid and everybody hated it?
And now it's...
And then it's just, now it's like, okay, now it's just the norm.
Yep.
Now it's like, how can I edit this down to be a vertical format?
They laughed at me at the Institute. That's what it's like. Who's laughing now?
They laughed at me at the Institute.
I mentioned vertical videos. And they told me I was crazy.
It is weird just how much more effective scrolling up and down is versus side to side. Because if you do it horizontal, you have to scroll side to side to get from video to video.
That's
like
true.
Snapchat tried. But somehow the scrolling up and down.
Great play.
Smart
great
wow.
play. I mean, great volleys, too. They just kept improving his Sean, court position.
I don't care that you broke your elbow. Yeah.
Yeah, sure.
Dead ringer. He also shares a likeness with Jackie Gleason.
Great return.
And I think that takes us to 5-3.
It does.
Indeed. A hard-fought first set thus far, coming in just at the hour mark here.
That's right. At the place where we have the 355 open, it's 53. Nice.
57 minutes into the stream.
Look at the... No way.
Wow.
Oh, that was close.
That was one of those relatively ill-advised shots, but he almost pulled that off, so what do I know?
Jackie Gleason always cracks me up because it makes me think of this. Hey, Sean, I think you'll appreciate this from Archer. Where
is
there's
it because
a large...
he's chubby that you're bringing it up to me?
No. Well, yes. Yeah, but there's a more large-set woman on Archer, and the mom, who plays the mom on Arrested Development, also plays the mom on Archer, and she goes... and she goes, she's like... And yet Pam is surprisingly light on her feet. It's like if you've ever seen Jackie Gleason dance. And then Pam goes, so is that a compliment? And then Mallory goes, well, I don't see how it possibly could be.
Well, I don't see how it possibly could be.
Oh.
Not too costly, so to speak.
Now.
Speaking of compliments.
Well, it could have been set point, so the other way.
Clipped
so.
The line. And they continue.
Flip the Line, that's a pretty good band name.
Yeah. Now skip the bridges, buddy.
Nice.
Volley. He's just off his back foot, he can do that. Wonder what it's like to have talent. Nice. Good roller. Just get it to die a little bit more. That's smart. Oh, he picked
nice
it.
Dig.
Unbelievable.
Yep.
Thought that was going to be a problem. What do I know?
Peter's able to pull that off on a regular basis, but when he steps up like that, he's covering the whole court.
Pretty much.
You know what I mean? Like, he steps in front of the baseline in case there's a drop shot.
Wow, come that on. Stayed in.
Nice dig. Two in a row. Yes, he got it. Great shift there by Andrew.
That's funny.
Read that early.
That backhand was coming down. He's got so much top on
nice
that
pick.
Thing.
Oh,
it's gonna sit.
A little wide,
oh.
Yeah.
Unbelievable.
Great
D.
Point.
From Burka Steinman.
Both teams there.
Unbelievable. Yeah, no question. All right. An opportunity here to climb back in.
Can they handle it?
That's good hands.
So casual on the
redrive. Swung at it. Let me show you how comfortable I feel. I'm going to swing at this one.
It is crazy that these guys these seem like the type of guys they'll stay in a match no matter what the score is. But every single point feels like the intensity is just building as we get further. Whereas me, as soon as it's love 15 in the first game, I give up. So.
Oh!
That's tough.
Well, if you're going to miss it, I suppose. This
I mean,
cushion.
He
right.
read it. He read
did.
It
he
really
did.
Early. If anything, he might have, you know, maybe he looked to the target before it came off his paddle, but it seemed like he was right there. It's interesting to see Andrew ramp up the speed of the spin as the match goes on. Ball's moving more now than it was at 2-1.
Yep, and it's getting a little
And it just hugs the side screen enough.
Unbelievable.
Don't call it a comeback. Because they're up. That would be unwise.
Shot. No.
Good pressure there.
That was a great, yep. I mean, just a super, super screen drive. Almost a chip or kind of a flat roll, if you will, Coach.
Yeah, and, off that and crazy Steinman angle. With the blitz off of Peter's low drive is probably what causes the error there. I mean, it, you know, Andrew sees him coming and has to hit a perfect volley.
Oh, and there.
That is tough. 5-4.
Inching back.
We're going to change ends.
Yeah. I don't know. I just can't. It hurts my soul to see a chicken wing fail. I'm always rooting for whoever's chicken winging.
You're more of a thigh guy?
Yeah, just like the talk about
the shot.
I don't
want to touch any of this commentary.
It's, you know, it'll only get better.
Yeah, that joke went over my head. Yeah. Sean, why don't you connect to Bluetooth and let's listen to your voicemails?
I was just going to think of that. I was going, if I play it, it's going to come out over the air.
But do we have that kind of time?
I can go back over
half
the
of them
bios
are me.
Again. Let's do that.
Hey, Sean, just calling again.
Hey, Sean, it's Matt. I didn't really have anything. I just wanted to call and say what's up.
Beep. I got to tell
you. Do you know where there's any good queso?
So hard to find good queso these days.
Do you have any queso in your car?
Here, I'm gonna add, because I don't think I got every fact off of these resumes. So
that's okay. I'm sure there's more. A couple of great resets there from Steinman.
Without
and a
doubt.
Really
Look
smart play
Come
there
on.
From Peter to keep the ball away from Andrew as he started to get comfortable in that point with some good lobs.
Oh. You know what, Coach? It's funny you mentioned that. That's a feel you have, too. Where you could just feel somebody growing in confidence, or you could feel the other way around, where you feel like somebody, you know,
nice
what?
Hands again, really
losing confidence,
drive.
And you get that idea, and you just figure, you know, let's pick on this
and,
person.
And that's also one of the things that, I mean, I hate to say it, but again, it comes up where somebody will be like, "Hey, I thought you told us to hit like 90% of the balls to that player. Why are you hitting three and then moving it to the other side of the court?" And the answer is because if I hit three,
wow. There's that one ender.
Just
I agree
flicked
with you, though,
it to
Coach.
The open court.
I
because if I
you.
Hit that same shot three times in a row, someone's going to jam it down my throat.
Exactly.
So you end up having to, you know, you end up having to move the
you
ball and swing it more and change spin and speed.
Everybody swing. No, here's a real quick fun fact about Pete Burka. Apparently one of the best paddle points ever played. Of course, that's a tall, long list, but... was Mitchell and Schmidgall and Parsons with Burka in 2016, and they say you can YouTube that thing.
The point is still going?
Yeah, apparently, and you can YouTube it. So it's a live stream in and of itself, I guess, is what it is. That pen.
Man, that little one-handed
that
backhand poke is really...
Working, paying dividends, if you will.
It's well, I mean, he's just making him cover so much court with it.
Yeah.
It's just...
You can kind of hold it a little bit.
Yeah.
There, if you will.
It's he's just shaping the drive really well right now.
Well.
Great return there. Oh, he got it. Let cord clip and on the line.
So here's a one extra fun fact about Robert Steinman, Pete Burka's partner. He upset the number one seed in doubles at the Kalamazoo tournament, and that happened to be Jack Sock.
Mm.
I'd call that a good win.
Yeah, I agree.
Jeez, he's one of the best double players in the world. That's impressive, very impressive. Good lob. Oh, yes. Again, showing the versatility.
So a double set point here. As Sean would like to say, serving to stay in it.
Exactly. Double set points. Does that mean he wins two sets if he wins?
Yep.
Stupid. I always wondered about that, actually.
Well, now you have your answer.
There's got to be another way to say it, but no. Good lob. I agree to Coach Hong is kind of rolling. It's almost like they say the force is strong in that one.
Do they say that?
That's what they say. I don't know who they are, but that's what they say.
Midichlorians was a stupid idea. Jeez.
By the way, I just realized that Andrew Ong is just putting most of us to shame with his free time. Apparently, he's not only was an A student, but he was a big volunteer off the court and still is.
Wow.
What a volley. Come on.
Oh, great shot. Sick. Oh, man.
Sicko.
Get your Let protractors court, out.
Come on. Jeez. What's the algorithm on that?
No, just a really little deep.
The judgment from Burka there.
And the resident optometrist is quickly giving eye examinations on the court. So Peter is good for at least another calendar year. One more set point.
Oh, yes. Big credit on court two as Will Colmar just went tweener to recover in the corner and stayed in it.
There's something you don't hear very often. Wrong. Colmar with a tweener. I think we don't go an hour before we hear Colmar with the tweener. Nah, good player and good guy. Will Colmar.
He's been a guest host.
Yeah.
On CPTC.
That's
Live.
Right. Excellent commentator.
He's actually, I just got confirmation today. We've got him on the roster
Seriously?
For a few matches, yeah,
Beautiful.
To commentate.
Yeah. We don't even have
Last time he brought his high noon and made the CPTC Live drinking game.
I was just going to say, I don't know if we can even, endorse that, but we're going to.
Oh, geez, it can't get worse than me, Sean. I don't understand what would be the problem.
Well,
we could have McClure continue to live stream, or Will could do it while inebriated. I think we should have Will do it, don't you?
Who was that other guy, that other loser, other than Cal?
Nice Albrecht. Dig by Mitch.
Wow. Really good dig. That was just falling like Niagara.
Wow.
Cal.
Good no, yeah, when people nice. Think of CPTC Live, they think of me. That's why everybody calls me Kyle when I meet them for the first time.
I've heard you referred to as Kale an awful lot lately as well.
Kyle.
That's Kale.
And shout out to the guy at Exmoor, I won't name drop, that thought my name was Chad.
Wow. You don't really leave.
You have a strong
like
chin.
A
I see it.
Hey. Yeah, maybe.
You're such a Chad.
I don't mind being called the wrong name. That way I don't feel bad if I call somebody else.
You're such a Brittany.
Jesus.
What is the Breakfast Club? Or no, not Babysitter's Club.
I got to get back to these fun facts because...
Yeah, that's Sean's favorite book.
Degenerating.
Series.
This is degenerating.
More
than
like
it normally
my arthritis.
Is. Mitch Granger. Oh, by the way, he played number one singles for Grays Lake 3 out of 4 years.
Oh, that is a huge point.
I'll tell you what.
Fighting off double match point to stay in it.
I'm going to be disappointed if both of these sets do not end in a tiebreak.
I agree.
And then the third set also goes to a tiebreak because I don't want to sleep tonight.
Anything could happen.
That's a great shot. No.
Oh, sneaky.
Almost hit it too hard.
Yep. Oh, that's tough. That was a lot of height changes on those drives between Andrew and Mitch on that last sequence.
Get another opportunity to see if they can close out this
caught
set.
Chasing that one up a little high.
It happens.
Now, I don't know why this just came to me, but I'm gonna tell this to Mitch directly, but I think he's missing out if he doesn't go on a business venture of a custom-brewed beer called Mitch's Brew. Mm. Or the Mitch's Brew.
Yeah, Mitch's
Maybe
Brew
it's
is
like
great.
Like a Halloween.
Good opportunity.
Maybe it's green.
I think I got it.
We could probably start it with some type of homebrew situation and see if we can get it to take off.
The Mitch's Brew. He'd have to get nose surgery probably for, like, the marketing aspect.
You're taking
it
too far.
In post.
Yeah, I think so.
It would just the label would just be a cauldron, and it just says Mitch's Brew.
Yeah, that's good.
Just keep it simple.
All black can with, like, a green, green
The non-alcoholic version would be called My Pretty.
It's a deep cut, Sean.
I'm deep into the marketing.
Disney called, and we're no longer on the air.
There it is.
And there.
That is huge.
What a set of paddle.
First set, 6-4. Granger Ong taking it after multiple match points. That was probably a third match point there in order to convert. And we will be right back with set number two after these words from our sponsor, IBJ High.
From the heart of Chicago up to the North Shore and stretching from the northwest suburbs down to Kankakee, from urgent in-office care to virtual in-home visits, we're making orthopedic care available wherever and however you need it. Because while we're adapting our lives to keep each other safe, we know that new injuries will happen and old injuries will still linger. And IBJI is here to help.
Illinois Bone and Joint Institute is the best choice for orthopedic care. Our walk-in ortho access clinics provide treatment by orthopedic specialists without a trip to the ER. With evening and weekend hours, we provide your family with excellent care when it matters most. Visit IBJI.com to find an ortho access immediate care.
Friday the 27th, what?
We're back. We'd be streaming for charities.
We're back.
Oh, we are?
Well, we'll see. Obviously not. Oh, that's
there,
what
there we go. I knew we'd figure it out eventually.
So a special thanks to Illinois Bone and Joint. Wintrust, which is who Sean keeps his money with, and Viking.
Yes.
The venerable
high-performance paddle.
Yeah.
Of the platform tennis industry.
And I'm not just saying this as because they're our sponsor. This is just an objective truth. I thought for the longest time the Viking were the only people that made paddles. Because anytime I go into a country club, you see the little symbol on the paddle. And I thought that's just like, oh, that's just a paddle. That's just
see,
what a
I
paddle
thought it was
like.
That Vikings were the only people that played paddle. I didn't.
You had to be a Viking. Okay, all right. Paddle. I see yeah. Where you're headed there.
That's another
it's
true
a Norse
story.
Game. It's like a Norse game.
I asked Matt
stupid joke.
If you dyed your hair.
Me?
Yeah, because you have this like black hair and then the white beard. And Matt just goes, no, he's just Norse. Or something along those lines.
My hair is the only thing
it's
that's
impressive.
Norse, man.
It's impressive.
Yeah. No, I don't. I'm not a color my hair
No, of
guy.
Course not. Well, and it was the first time I met you. I was like, man, is this guy like somehow, how's he got the snowy white beard? And you had a longer
yes.
beard at that point
yeah,
as well.
Yeah.
Sean Albrecht of a seafaring folk.
Yeah, I'd buy it.
Hi, laddie.
You'd be good at the sea shanties.
I don't know.
Although
would,
they might
I,
throw you
I,
overboard for going through James Morrison on it. They're just trying to sing about, you know.
All right, so minor adjustments here coming from Burka Steinman. It wasn't like there was huge errors that came out of that last set. That was pretty tight. Granger Ong with a couple of key drives to really stretch out Burka Steinman at the net, but otherwise just a pretty straight up.
And just missed
solid
a
solid set of paddles. So let's see how number two goes. Could go either way. We could have a real fast 6-1. I wouldn't expect it, but it's not impossible in some of these situations. That's a,
I'll put my
a
entire,
new ball there, Peter.
Yeah. I'll put my entire family's house on Peter and Robert 6-1-ing them. That seems like a solid bet. Safe bet.
It just sounded like you're talking about 37 people. My entire extended family is at their house.
If I had the money. I'm very good with bats.
Gosh, just so tough in the world of paddle to maintain the same kind of level of focus and intensity after a set like that. Because it's just so much. You've invested so much already in
those 10 games. Actually, we're going to call Rob Steinman. Brock Purdy finally threw an interception there. He finally missed a backhand. After a set with, and of course, he's back on his streak again. That's a good waterfall. Look at this. It's a taco. Just crazy.
Nice get.
Serving it on a platter.
Oh. He did take a chance on that, even knows
yeah,
it.
Yeah, he thought about, yeah. yeah. As soon as he made contact, you could tell he was trying to be a little more aggressive with the lob.
Yep.
Oh, good stretch.
Wow. Great touch from Granger. I'm not talking about the distributor, by the way. I'm talking about Mitch. Because it did sound that,
either,
like I was saying.
Either is
great
fine.
Touch from Granger.
Granger. Yep.
What a shot.
Great patience from Peter.
Because I was pretty impressed by it. Granger's flat overhead in the corner there. And apparently Burka just didn't think much of it. Slapped that poke drive. We had a little break in the action here.
What's going on? Are we getting some heaters on?
Maybe. Is it getting a little wet out there, Coach?
I mean, it's possible.
Look at that. Andrew
Andrew's
hang on
throwing
to
his paddle. Guys are taking
in
time
that's
bomb of fury.
That's how moist it is out there, Coach.
Pure rage. It's what he's most known for.
Yeah.
He's basically the Incredible Hulk of paddle.
Bruce Banner. Or David Banner.
Bruce
Depends
Banner.
On the series. Depends
that's
on the series.
That's a great drive, keeping
shot.
It low and compact.
Yeah.
Super solid.
All right, a hold point here for Hong and Granger. There's a wing for you there, Cal.
Yeah.
Nice.
Oh,
wow.
That thing came way farther out down the side screen
tell
than
you what,
anybody
Hong
was expecting.
Hong and Granger are just playing smart
yep.
paddle. Yeah. I mean, if there is such a thing as, hey, man, we're just going to hit the right shot at the right time, pretty much 99% of the time, I think they pretty much figured it out. Because it's not as though Burka and Steinman were playing poorly. Part of it was just, you know, you get into situations. I mean, not many people are going to pull that shot off anyway. What did he mean? He's pointing for it.
Yeah, I don't know who he's pointing at. Thought it was me. It was not me.
He wants the cheese platter? I don't know. What does he want?
I would love a cheese platter.
Well,
right
if
now.
You can get a charcuterie board delivered to you on court, it's always a great play.
Hey, this is Medina. And there's nothing's impossible.
Yeah, I mean, if you...
You want... You, this is what you
if
want.
You don't
this
have,
is what
if you
get.
Don't have some spiced nuts in the back room, then I'm just not interested anymore.
I'm just going to say it. I can't even believe how hard Pete Burka could hit his paddle serve with not as much spin as most people have on it. It's amazing. He smacks it. Look at this. Get out.
Jeez.
I was going to say, if he pulls that off...
This is
quite
volleys, the dipper.
Right, exactly. Half volleys are not exactly...
It seems like the temperature has dropped significantly because we can see their breath. I'm just noticing that because it was like 65 when we pulled up here.
Well, there's
it was
also,
actually very nice out.
There's also the possibility, and this is where maybe where the heaters are coming in, Cal, is it's not only getting colder, it's getting a little bit more humid because it can stay, say, 50 to somewhere degrees and then get more humid, and then you can still see some... breath coming
the
off.
The humidity.
Yeah.
That was Trey Scott and I's cover band name was going to be The Heat and the Humidity.
I like it.
Let's check AccuWeather. Sean is the one that turned me on to AccuWeather. I was a weather channel.
You mean
channel.
As opposed to the weather channel?
The first one's
yeah.
free.
Yeah.
It's because the app is better.
Yeah.
Okay.
The best,
forcing
the
retreat.
Yeah.
Steinman causing lots of problems now as he's able to close up on the net.
Well, Sean was right. It is 51 out. Very impressive, Sean.
Just get a few for these things when you get to be 80 and 90 years old.
That's true.
And
plus parts of your body start to hurt with the change in barometric pressure.
Yeah.
That's one of the things.
That's true. Shout out
what
to anybody.
Nice.
Oh, wow.
That was
shot.
A sneaky waterfall
that
from
was.
That position from Steinman.
It was.
Really not, I think, what Andrew was expecting.
And he was trying to take a chance on maybe taking it on the rise, too.
Shout out to everybody that misses Dark Sky. It really
what
was
happened?
The best.
Did they get bought?
Apple bought them and implemented none of it. They just didn't want the competition. So if you needed more evidence that Apple is the worst... Dark Sky.
Well, at least
I
you're
can
not
forgive almost ever. I can forgive the headphone jack. I can't forgive Dark Sky.
That's where you draw the line.
I loved Dark Sky.
Come on, look at me. I'm the guy that every time I was at a party, I needed
nice
the weather
pick.
App.
Oh, my gosh. It was in.
Oh, how did it drop? He's got that honeymoon afterglow.
I was with Peter on that one. I would have let that ball go as well.
That's
just
what it
didn't
is.
Didn't look it's, like it was going to.
Part of it's got to be the honeymoon afterglow, Coach.
It didn't look like it was going to come down. Great
I know
return.
I didn't miss a forehand for at least 3 or 4 hours. And right on cue.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, my.
It is a break point for On Granger. Shot. Let's get a. Oh, yeah.
Good
He's
spot.
There. He's
Good
there.
Spot.
I've seen Pete hit too many toss and backhands. Forgot he has that shot as well. Lest we forget. Sit. Oh.
It's a great point.
Staying in it.
Both teams working the transition.
Back to deuce.
Smart.
Yeah. Let's make a pawn. I think I'll back up and
I'll take a step
ball.
Back and take a cutter forehand slice.
I was gonna try
inside
to
out
blitz, but I think I'll
inverted.
Back.
That's just such
Tweeter
a good
shot.
Such a good play.
Nice touch
from Mitch to slow it down and get that ball to drop.
Exactly. Perfect
close
example of again, you don't want to hit the ball that hard sometimes, especially if you have your opponent retreating. Such a know-it-all. When I say that. It's a good shot.
That's a good spot as well.
Again, the one and a half, if
Two
you will, one-hander.
2-0.
From Ong with surprising pace on it. I'm telling you, I don't think Rob maybe thought that he was going to put that kind of pace on it. Not many people did. Shot.
Yep, good hands.
Wow, so to stay in there. He is quick.
As Peter started to decide that he was going to reclose on that one.
Yep.
He was in charge.
Reclose, yeah. I've done that plenty of times.
The reclose.
When the house, the loan doesn't go through.
Are you closing or are you reclosing?
Or are you just Glenn Close?
Mm.
Wow.
So talented.
I mean, come on, Air Force One.
We're reaching. You're just reaching. Yeah, she was pretty good in that, actually.
No, she wasn't.
I thought she
was. No.
That was a good cartwheel volley from Mitch.
Tough.
Oh.
I'm telling you, Steinman's just dangerous off the ground. This gives you an idea where paddle is concerned of how important it is to be able to drive the ball or how unimportant it is to be able to drive the ball. Because, I mean, you can get away with that stuff. Whoops. In tennis, you can just see why he's a terror out there. It's a nice pick. Yeah, that's the other thing you were mentioning, Coach. You get some people who will say, hey, I saw Rob Steinman play off the net and half volley the ball.
Right.
We're just telling everybody to close.
Just add it to the list of things that no one should do.
I think, I'm telling you, I think it is literally where Andrew Rong will hold the ball, if you will, with that one-hander. I'm telling you, I think that's part of what makes it disconcerting.
Yep.
This is a big point.
The dreaded third game hold point.
Oh God. No!
I mean, missile. I mean, just total missile off that backhand side.
That was tough because, I mean, there's nothing you can do there if you're Mitch.
No.
Of course, when the ball clips the tape, you're going to kind of, you know,
chase it up. He's gotten a couple of those
and
as well.
It might have gone out. It might have been clipping the tape and going out of bounds, but it's just tough
but didn't it hit?
You can't read it that fast.
Exactly.
Well, for an important point, Robert had an important answer.
The lob volley. Yeah, you got to love that. He's teaching a lesson out there, isn't he?
He's putting on a clinic.
No way.
That's just such great help. Good coverage from Peter as well to shift in and out of position to help cover. Nice dig.
Oh, he tries for the flip. And again, hasn't missed one of those all match, except for
It's
now.
Interesting because that was almost enough of a floater where he was like, you know, it was right to him. It's sort of not what he was expecting, and then didn't take the step.
That's a big serve.
Chicken wing. All right, they have to win this point.
Nice. I think that's the rule.
That is such a great ball from Mitch to get
the
that ball
wing.
To drop down again. So 3-0.
I'm not rooting for anybody, for the record.
Zero.
Sure you're not there.
People just saw me fist bumping. I'm not rooting. I'm
Stop
rooting for the chicken
rooting.
Wing.
We're an hour and 30 minutes into this match. 6-4 first set. If you're just joining us, this is the Legends event here at Medina. And we have the benefit of another event coming up in just a few days.
Yep.
There's an APTA Grand Prix event that is the Medina Tournament.
Yep.
Can
we call
one.
It the Medina Cup, Coach?
I don't know if there is a cup.
Okay, well, you don't have to drink out of it, but I'm just saying maybe there's something, you know. Well,
I mean, a chalice?
Something we can dig up around.
It's a saucer, technically.
Around the shed out there.
The Medina Chafing Dish Open.
The chalice with the from the palace.
The
palace has the brew that is true.
Brew that is true.
They broke the chalice with the palace, and they replaced
brew.
It with a flagon of the dragon.
Chalice. Well, first of all, you're too young.
The pellet with the
that.
Poisons and the chazzle from the plasma. Danny Kaye is a national treasure.
You know what? I don't think there was a better performance in a movie.
Billy Crystal, Harry Met Sally, drop mic.
All right, stop. You know, really?
First Women of all, love
he
Billy
didn't
Crystal.
Sing
he
one
didn't sing
music.
Or
he
dance.
Sing one thing
you don't
that.
Understand.
No,
you don't
he,
understand the
he
movie.
He is the greatest. Right. That is the greatest acting performance, period.
Okay.
Oh, that's a tough backspin volley there.
It really stayed low. Did not come up proverbially for air, if you will. That thing just bowling for dollars.
What was that a reference
to? There's a reference to something from the 70s there, Callie. You'll never get the... there was a touch.
I was getting
a reference,
but it's probably a bad reference.
But you've got it. No, you've got that. There is a movie with Danny Kaye, and you should see this movie, even though it's going to be lost on you. And he pounded that thing.
It's a good scramble.
Yep. Up the joint
lead from Peter.
The joint return.
Would it be insensitive to start calling Mitch Granger?
Yes.
Yeah, probably.
I don't even want you to finish that story. The man just got married.
Nice rip. Man, that's tough.
I was going to say the animal orphanage, also known as the pound.
Good.
Mitch the Pound Granger. My God. Somebody get this man off the court.
There it is again. I'm telling you, just in case you missed it, here it is again. That's that one I'm talking about. It just looks like he just holds it. And he doesn't necessarily hold it. He just kind of waits on it a bit.
Well, it's also, I mean, part of it is how long he holds it. But then he comes up with that angle from that position.
Yeah.
It's just, I mean, you're just not going to cover that ball.
You're thinking there's no way.
Oh. Nice pick there by Mitch.
Wow.
And the recovery. And the dig on the volley. Good, smart.
Look at the touch.
Also, Mitch just anticipating and jumping just in case.
I was with Mitch on that one. If I had hit that half lob volley thing, I also would have thought the next ball was coming hard at me.
Well, that's nice. He's got it. Almost hit it again, too hard. But
it's a great read from Peter.
It was.
To bail on that early. He saw the big swing.
Yep. And still did it with some smooth guy style.
Mr. Smooth Guy.
That kind of applies to everybody here.
Triple drive.
Tough to do that. Not impossible. Just tough to do it maybe at a high rate of speed there.
Mr. Ong to serve.
All right, 4-Z. They seem to be rolling here. I'm hoping that I'm not jinxing them. Oh, well.
Oh, jeez. That's tough.
Love that eye formation.
Yep. It's gonna. Oh, look at the tomahawk. He's there.
Wow.
So there are two schools of thought. Not to reach out to. I don't even know. I'll bet you Spencer's watching.
Nah.
Don't you think so? No.
Okay. Yeah.
Maybe.
Sure.
So what I'm thinking is because she brought this up and I think she had a great point one day, at back at the
solid
old hunt.
Solid volley there.
And I wonder if she brings it up again because I think she's absolutely right about this. She says she's not a big fan of I formation coach because for a number of reasons, you know, popping up especially in paddle. What do you think?
Yeah, if you are not used to coordinating it with your partner, it can be more trouble than it's worth.
Yep.
Now, with that said, just because you're uncomfortable doesn't mean you shouldn't try it, because part of the reason that you're doing it is to take away some kind of shot that's hurting you.
Agreed.
Otherwise, there'd be no reason, you know. So one of those things that is super annoying is when, you know, a player who's learning is like, oh, no, let's not do it. I'm not comfortable with it.
Right.
But the reason that you're doing it is because you lost the first set 6-1 and it's 3-0.
Right.
And, like, yeah, at that point, I don't think that staying out of I formation is going to be the big catalyst for,
exactly.
for the win or loss.
I agree. On the board, by the way, for Burka and Steinman. So a really hard-fought but well done on their part to get on the board here, because anything could happen in this second set here at lovely bucolic Medina Country Club. Only reason I ask is because there's obviously the alternative of going Australian. In other words, you'd just be on one side.
I'm a little bit more of a fan of the Australian as well.
That's
I think the I formation really requires coordination, and the person who's up there has to really love, you know, moving towards and cutting off the first volley.
Yep.
And so I think Australian allows you to change the formation but still be, you know, kind of locked in your position.
Without a doubt. The other thing is I think if you play with a partner on a regular basis and you kind of know each other and you pretty much know what your tendencies are going to be, especially if they're – and they commit. Because let's face it, I've probably been this doubles partner. I've been the guy at the net saying I'm going to go to the right and I go to the left, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So – you got to pretty much, you know, commit and stay with it. But the other thing is, if you play with somebody on a regular basis and you have enough chemistry with them, I guess you can get away with it. But I'm kind of with Spencer on that I would favor definitely an Australian over after having played paddle for, well, just as many years as I have.
I just like to move around at the net enough until my partner hits me in the back of the head with a serve, and then I know.
For the rest of the match.
That it's time to move on.
I'm just selfish. I don't like to shoot. That was a great shot from Steinman.
Yeah, good cut.
Beautiful touch. When I say touch, I mean he hit that pretty hard, but that had so much spin on him, just dying like a quail.
Yeah, I mean, at this point, I think probably Burka Steinman are just looking to, like, keep enough pressure on,
you know,
Granger and Ong, where maybe they cool off a little bit, you know?
Exactly.
Because they've certainly played pretty hot for these last few games in a row, and it's a big part of the strategy sometimes is staying alive.
Yeah, sorry about the noise. I've decided to do some light jackhammering. That's it. It stayed in.
Wow.
Yeah, I wanted to make... Did it stay in?
No.
And it just bad luck. It was a great...
wide.
That was a great shot from Steinman. Bad luck there. It would have been nice. He's on that one. That's nice touch. Able to get it. It's good depth. Oh, yeah. Dig. I don't think there's a ball that's low enough where Andrew Ong can't get down to it.
Yeah,
it's crazy.
There's...
like right here. Look at that. It doesn't take much out of him either. And admittedly, it's difficult with the waterfall in this weather to make it die back there. So maybe a bad example, but still.
Not for Rob under the radar Steinman. He's had a couple die in the corner.
Under the radar UTR. Kind of poetic.
Yep.
Haven't seen one of those in a while.
That was a good dig. Mitch really baited him into that.
I was going to say, if he pulls this one off, because he's just kind of smoothly going back there. That last one, that very last one, just required a little bit more footwork. But, I mean, I would have been laying on the court by that time. Just tell you what, Steinman's handling that.
Good spot. Yep.
Come on.
That is a good spot.
So much spin on it, it almost came back. Great top from Mitch Granger. Oh, yeah.
Trying to capitalize, but great volley. Andrew might not have caught that one as clean as he was hoping.
No, but I got to tell you something. I think Rob's pretty much relegated himself to the idea that anything coming down the line off that side, he's pretty much
he's going
to
do something with it.
Down.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I really like Mitch finding ways to drive from both sides of the court.
Yeah. He'll walk a mile for that forehand. Beauty. Great lob. Jeez. No mid decision there, but they handle it.
Just a little bit, but good shot from Peter to get out of trouble. It's the big one there.
He's there.
Yep. Great help.
Just to give you an idea, of course, we are getting the 8:13 is to Brussels is flying over out here. But just so you know. You're hearing a fair amount of communication, but these guys, you know, pretty much can get an idea of whether or not. Oh, yeah.
Jeez.
Nice pick, Pete. Yep. Oh, yeah. Look at the touch. Come on.
Oh,
what
that
a
is
shot.
Such a good sequence right there.
Yeah.
Peter able to dig out a couple of really difficult balls in transition. And then Steinman able to keep his balance on a few drive sequences.
Definitely. I also like the fact that Rob's backhand, pretty much on a regular basis, you let it go and it's staying in. It's not as though he's driving that thing flat enough where, you know, just if you let it go at shoulder high, it's out of there. I'm telling you, that thing's snapping down.
Yep.
And in this weather, of course, it is getting colder or chillier.
Yeah, it's dropping a little bit. This is that, you know, kind of like, this is the kind of awesome paddle conditions where it's not like the ball is like launching off your paddle all the time, you know, but everybody, if you're still comfortable.
Oh, yeah. Something you don't see very often, a lob that you let bounce into that. It happens. One timer.
A good stretch. Truly finding a lot of ways to drive to different targets in the backcourt.
Going after a drive there.
There is an opportunity. So
he set it up.
They're able to grind it out, 4-2. Steinman Burka maybe with a little momentum.
You know what, I got to appreciate Andrew Ong for that shot. Now, I know that if you are, it's a game point for your opposition. Maybe you try that, maybe you don't, but I kind of respect the idea of staying aggressive, and I like the move.
Well, if you're Andrew Ong, is there a reason where that would be a bad decision? I mean, with your percentages at this point, I'm not even sure that I would say, you know, he's hitting it off his backhand.
Yeah, and not only that, go ahead.
Well, he's hitting it off his backhand, and when he's been stepping into the ball like that, he's converted so many.
Most of the time. Absolutely. And not only that, you kind of have to, as they say, dance with who you brought to the prom, you know?
I've only ever heard you say that.
They haven't gone to try to play a different style. They've been successful up till now with what they've been doing. Why would you not try? Because he's been doing that up till now, you know what I mean? They've been aggressive. Of course, as I say that, you know, Mitch hits one.
Well, I mean, maybe a whiff of, you know, an opportunity here. Sort of what we were talking about, right? Like, if they can keep the pressure high, that maybe Mitch and Andrew will, you know, cool off a little bit. I mean, they haven't missed that many, you know, even when they're taking risk, they haven't missed that many shots. And so it's...
That's one of my favorite shots from Pete, is pretty much his poke drive.
Mm-hmm.
That's
the, well,
got, like
got
right
it.
There, like right there.
Yep.
The height, it's got a little higher over the net than you'd even think it would be, but it kind of gets on you quickly enough where you can't really do much with the volley, and then if you let it go, that's what happens.
He's got such great pace control. And I mean, I've talked to him about that shot before. He is actually trying to hit it at a height where you feel like you have to let it go.
Yeah.
And it's going to drop in, you know, a couple inches inside the baseline every time.
Impressive.
But it's sneaky.
I mean, you just don't see that very often.
Also, we just witnessed a vintage triple fist bump.
Yeah. Nice dish.
I mean, it's not as many fist bumps as Eric Moran, but that's tough. Good hands. Great volley.
Steinman.
I think Mitch is just a... irritated about the decision, you know, rather than...
Apparently, considering what the on-court mic just picked up.
All right, that's enough.
Oh, yeah, he's there. Look at the speed.
Oh, my yikes.
Come on.
And he's there, too. Yeah, why don't you just get everything?
Yes.
Good dig there as well. Everyone just... Yes!
No!
Oh, that's
They're
a great
human.
Point.
Here we go.
Mixing it up on both sides. So all of a sudden.
It's past interesting.
Suddenly Susan, as they say.
It's been Susan interesting the whole time, pretty much.
4-3.
If that makes sense. I was just trying to be topical. Yeah. I'm out of fun facts, by the way, Coach. I read everything that was on those pages. So forgive me.
Yeah,
we can start making stuff up.
That's okay. No, I think we should start making stuff up.
That.
Okay.
That's typically how we operate, but we're going to continue.
Well, shout out to my Yonex team.
I don't usually do this,
but we have a national. I know we have a national sales meeting tomorrow morning, and I'm really looking forward to it. Doesn't it look that way?
You know, Andrew Ong, you know, not a big-time rackets player, but not just that, also, you know, fully certified as a Zumba instructor.
Is he really?
Which has a lot to do
with
his success in the screens as he, you know, pirouettes.
Wow.
Just great control of the hip flexors.
It's really funny. So my wife will go to an exercise class. I probably should be going with her, right, Cal?
It's always just you.
I know.
Just by yourself.
I know. So she'll go to the exercise class, and I'll always call it Zumba.
Just to annoy her.
It's not Zumba. But, okay, would you have a good time with your Zumba class? Stop calling it that.
I went through a period like that with my kids where they thought every activity was... Oh, wow. Nice volleys.
Yeah.
Where they thought every workout was jazzercise. I had them convinced that that's all exercise was jazzercise.
Jazzercise.
Well, I think both of them are right. I think Pete doesn't necessarily miss volleys like that, and maybe even try some like that. But I don't agree that Rob's overhead wasn't all that great. I think sometimes you just get out of position. Like right there. Besides, these guys are drilling the ball. Great
shot. Wow, nice cutter.
This is where the racket skills come in right here, because that was, I mean, obviously it was a bounce cutter, so to speak, but that's using your racket skills for good, like the Justice League, I guess. Volley. I didn't want to go DC Comics for everybody.
As opposed to using his racket skills for the forces of evil.
There? Yeah, exactly.
That's true. Like Djokovic.
Nice. Djokovic is evil.
Using his racket skills for the forces of evil.
Oi.
Oh, bummer.
Was that in?
No, it clipped and went. It clipped and went wide.
Sean, I feel like your humor is like that old math experiment where you put like 8 colored blocks in a bag and it's just between 3 colors and it's either unintelligent, untalented, or unathletic. And whichever one you pull, you just make a joke about it real quick. But it's always one of those three.
I'm glad you've analyzed.
Caught the corner.
Not being a
40-30 opportunity to bring this second set.
A fully certified psychologist, you seem to have...
to even Steven.
Exactly.
Who's Steven?
Just some guy. He likes to even things up.
It's even Steven.
Jerry Seinfeld, isn't it?
No, I think that's the guy that dated a 17-year-old.
Jerry?
He did.
When he was 18, maybe.
No, when he was 37. It's a true story. God bless. All right, here we go. Speaking of even Steven, I didn't have a follow-up to that. I was just
good.
Speaking about
I'm kind of glad you didn't. You're delving into a subject that I'd really rather you not elaborate on. Good lob.
I think we're getting an ad playing out there. Don't listen to it. It's not ours.
I think we get into trouble with YouTube for that, do we?
Maybe. Probably not.
I like showing the blitz there.
I'll talk to them about it. I mean, this is Medina. I'm pretty sure they can afford the $11 per month.
I was saying I really like the show of blitz there, so to speak, from Mitch on that one. Got at least threatened to. I mean, I suppose you could just sit back at that. What a beautiful lob that was.
Speaking of Medina, on the way in here, they have like half the mountain ripped up, or half the hill, I should say. Are they putting in a new course or completely changing one of them?
The pirouette.
Yeah, there must be some. There's some course construction going on. There's a lot of stuff out
there. Pretty serious, yeah.
These guys are constantly doing something. This is an internationally renowned golf course, so.
Yeah, that's true.
You know what gophers can do to a golf course? I don't think it's gophers, though. I think it's more design. There it is again.
All right, so Mitch and Andrew have collectively decided to...
Whoa!
That was a good shot.
He's kidding. He's kidding. It was a joke.
Hey, that was one motion. Hey, that was one motion. It's our call. Get into the argument.
All right. This is... Actually, this has turned into the match that it should have been in the first place. Every bit the match it was supposed to be anyway.
I mean,
it's almost like it was
super,
bound to happen.
Super,
you know,
common.
I mean? Yep.
Although really good teams, apparently, instead of losing a set, 0-6, will go down a little bit and then be able to right the ship.
Find a way to climb back. Exactly. Jump out of the boat and find a way to climb back in. How much of the wide serve is Pete going to give up? All of it.
Yep. That was good communication there.
Yep.
I was saying look for the spin to draw me
kinda
to the opposite side.
Glad they switched back there. I'm talking about Berka Steinman. I'm thinking you pretty much want Rob on that bad side with that backhand.
I mean, just the attempted drive off of that overhead with that spin.
Yeah. A little wide with the
serve. Serve was a little bit out, yep.
Now, just a hair.
15 all. Going with the...
We're at an hour and 51 minutes here, match time.
Oh, yeah. He says you can't hit a high backhand.
Anytime you can get, you know, a couple of sets that are right around the hour mark, you know everybody's grinding.
Oh, yeah.
Especially with all four players playing just, this speed.
Just long.
Yeah.
And up, I should say down 15-30. Another
great
solid serve.
Yep,
uncharacteristic couple of misses there off the backhand wing of Mr. Steinman. Don't get used to it. These kicks. Oh, that's a great shot.
Get there.
That was a great shot.
Did not clear.
I'm noticing Steinman looking at the blitz, which was a good move, by the way.
Yep.
But a great reaction from Andrew, and it looks like he's got a hold point here. Yeah, I thought, oh, you're kidding.
Smooth.
He pulled it off. Oh, yes.
Great dig by Peter on the recovery as well.
Olay.
Yeah.
Bullfighter.
That is some serious bite.
Just knocks around in the
ball.
Corner.
That's a statement game, huh?
Yeah, 5-4.
Yeah. Andrew, pinball on.
Really well played.
It was. Let's just see.
It looks like Adam Morgan's court just wrapped up. Try to get the score on that.
We could run updates, I guess. Could we?
Well, we usually do. We're still waiting for Matt's scripted fight to take place.
Well, I mean, it was supposed to be in the third set, so we'll see. See what happens.
Well, it's not the third set. He just hammered that thing.
Yep.
Did Granger. And Steinman still had it.
He read that real early.
Yes, he did.
Great play.
And again, I like the attitude. I mean, like I said, do you want to be that aggressive? Sometimes, yes, you do. You got to take a few chances, realize you're up.
Yeah, why not?
And you're playing against a very, very good team, and sometimes you got to take. He goes after it again.
Match.
Kind of used the screen for it.
Oh, yeah, wow.
Jeez.
Granger just taking over there.
Yep.
I just love the flex off the back screen to go get himself to the net. That was stylish. I mean, not just Lululemon. I'm talking about, like, you know. Sophisticated, you know,
yeah,
Western European.
Oh
yeah.
I was thinking like.
Oh, he goes after the. Oh, he, you know what? It was the right opportunity. Ball dropped a little too much on him, maybe. To go for the cutter.
I thought you were talking about pure style, like a Hillary Clinton pantsuit.
Listen, a pantsuit. Period. No matter who's wearing it, is really.
Yeah.
Just a little deep there.
Pantsuits are deep, yes. And
the pockets.
Yeah, especially Hillary's.
That gives you a lot of options.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Got to enjoy all the options you have.
And mobility.
Well, anyway, as we have been talking high fashion, Burke and Steinman have pulled even in this game. Good hands.
The power.
The power.
More. He was giving it all she's got, Captain.
Look at this. Oh! Hasn't missed one of those all evening. Come on, Cal. Where's the stat sheet?
Yeah, well.
No, he hasn't. Yes, he has.
I don't know. I don't know about that one.
All right. point to pull even.
Yeah.
5-4. Maybe it was just a punt that stayed in. Oh, yeah.
Just a little wide.
Grange is like, I'm going to hit that. No, I'm not.
Yeah.
Don't touch it.
He did the perfect amount of thinking.
Back to deuce. Oh, I like that shot.
That's
I
a
really
smart play.
Like
a
that shot
point here.
Mitch.
Oh, how the
smacking
turn
the
tables.
Rolls, but trying to catch him with to hit a half volley. And Pete can pull those off, by the way. It's not like he misses those on a regular basis. It's just not an easy ball at this stage of the match. Great lob. Staying steady.
Oh, yeah, bringing it right off the camera.
There.
Great dig.
Groundhog dig. Not anymore. Okay. Yeah. Pick. Really, really good communication from these guys. I like the move. It's good. Yes. How did he pick that? Man. Come on. I thought that was going to be serious problems. No way. It is.
Oh, that is a great match. Well played, going the distance, 6-4, 6-4, a couple of fantastic sets there.
Unbelievable. That was a great
match. Always
fan.
Like to see that, yeah. Awesome stuff there.
I feel like this is
Legends events.
Always the nature of racket sports, but I feel like 6-4, 6-4 is not an indicative score for how this match went.
No. I mean that sounds cliched the way you said it, Cal.
Yeah, but I mean, that's right. That's pretty solid.
Yeah.
A couple of sets there, and obviously, you know, maybe Steinman and Burke are not happy with, you know, crawling into a hole in that second
set.
That makes it tough. You know?
That's the tough part.
Yeah,
yes.
Just having
from
to
behind.
Come back and win multiple games in a row. But phenomenal match, great from all four of our players on the court.
Yes.
We are going to call it an evening here from Medina.
Yes.
And. Your next one is going to be from us on Friday here with the women's
match.
That's right. The ladies' match is coming to you Friday from the Medina tournament brought to you by the APTA. So.
Yeah, we got – when we'll have – I got to say thank you to our sponsors. And let's do it again.
Yeah.
I'm just kidding. You don't have to do that again.
Everybody.
Make sure – you just say –
have a great evening, and we will see you in a couple days.
You got it.
From the heart of Chicago up to the North Shore and stretching from the northwest suburbs down to Kankakee, from urgent in-office care to virtual in-home visits, we're making orthopedic care available wherever and however you need it. Because while we're adapting our lives to keep each other safe, we know that new injuries will happen and old injuries will still linger. And IBJI is here.
Illinois Bone & Joint Institute is the best choice for orthopedic care. Our walk-in ortho access clinics provide treatment by orthopedic specialists without a trip to the ER. With evening and weekend hours, we provide your family with excellent care when it matters most. Visit